You may ask, why do we stay up there if it's so dangerous? We stay because Anadevka is our home. And how do we keep our balance? Well, that I can tell you in one word. Tradition!
Away from us.
but he delivered a mule. But that's all settled now. Now we live in simple peace and harmony.
Wait.
Or do we have to do this today?
Oh.
horse lose his shoe just before the Sabbath?
Now that wasn't very nice, now was it?
So now if you pick on me, Ted,
bless me with five daughters and a life of poverty, what have you got against my horse?
Sometimes I think that when things get a little too quiet up there, you say to yourself, let's see what kind of mischief I can play on my good friend Ted here.
Ah, so you're finally here, my brethren.
I'll talk to you later.
Where's the horse?
You got invited to the blacksmith's for the Sabbath.
Hurry up, the sun won't wait for you. I have something to say to you.
As the good book says, heal us, O Lord, and we shall be healed. In other words, send us the cure. We have the sickness already.
I'm not really complaining.
After all, with your help, I'm starving to death. Dear God, you made many, many poor people. I realize, of course, it's no shame to be poor, but it's no great honor either. What would have been so terrible if I had but a small fortune?
If I were a rich man, oh dear Lord, I'd be really bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. If I were a billionaire rich, I'd build a diamond ring. I'd build a big tall house with the rooms by the dozen, right in the middle of the town, with a fine tin roof and real wooden floors below. There would be one long staircase just going up, and one even longer coming down, and one more leading nowhere, just for show. I'd fill my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see and hear, squawking just as noisily as they can, and each like
crazy and goose and a gas and a gun
will land like a trumpet on the ear, as if to say here lives a wealthy man. If I were a rich man, oh dear long and bitty bitty bum, if I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. If I were a very, very rich, I'd see my gold looking like a rich man's wife with a proper double chin, supervising meals to her heart's delight. I'd see her putting on airs and strutting like a peacock, oiled the happy mood she's in, screaming at the servants day and night. The most important man in town will come to fawn on me. They will ask me to advise them, like a Solomon the Wise. If you please, Reptavia, pardon me, Reptavia, posing problems that would cross a rabbi's eyes. Boy, 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 boy. And it won't make one bit of difference if I answer right or wrong. When you're rich, they think you really know. discuss the holy books with the learned men 7 hours every day. And that would be the sweetest thing of all. If I were a rich man, all day long and biddy biddy bum, if I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work. Lord, who made the lion and the lamb, you decreed I should be what I am. Would it spoil some vast eternal plan? If I were a wealthy man.
Good Sabbath.
today be any different?
Teddy, I have to tell you.
I'm praying.
Teddy, Laser Wolf wants to see you.
Wiltshire? What about?
I don't know, only that he says it's important.
What can be important? I have nothing for him to slaughter.
After the Sabbath, see him and talk to him.
Talk to him about what? If he's thinking about buying my new milk cow, he can forget it.
Teddy, don't be an ox, man. Send an important message. The least you can do is go and talk to him.
Talk to him about what? He wants to buy my new milk cow.
Talk to him.
All right, after the Sabbath, I'll talk to him.
Thank you. glasses.
All right.
Your first rally, Blazer.
What's the occasion? Are we planning for a party?
There might be a party. Maybe even a wedding.
A wedding? Wonderful. I should, like to help make the wedding merry, lead the dancing and so forth. For a small fee,
naturally. Naturally, and no wedding is... A wedding is no wedding without you and your fee.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Would you like a drink? Sit down here.
Vodka, schnapps,
vodka.
Life!
life, the higher. The sight of my daughter.
My wife. It gives you something to think about.
Something to drink about.
Drink the fire.
To life.
Red Morka.
Yes, ladies and
drink
well.
For everybody.
All right.
Thank you.
Papa? I always wanted a son. Only one a little bit younger than myself. Thank you, Your Honor. You are a good man. If I may say so, it's true, Bastion, you're not the Jew.
That's what I like about you, Ted. Always joking. And congratulations again for your daughter.
Thank you, Your Honor. Night. Dear God, did you have to send me news like that today of all days? It's true that we are the chosen people, but couldn't you choose someone else every now and then? Anyway, thank you for sending a husband for my daughter, Saito. Hi.
Matchmaker. They hold hands together. They even dance together. New dances, like this. I learned it here. Do you like it?
That it was not ordained that you should have all the comforts of life, and that we should have a little joy in our old age after all our hard work.
Little Red Tabby, may I speak to you?
Not now, Malta.
Oh, I would like to speak to you.
Not now, Malta. I have problems.
That's what I'd like to speak to you about. I think I can help.
Sure. Like a bandage can help a corpse. Goodbye, Malta. Well, goodbye.
Please listen to him, Papa.
All right. You have a talk.
I hear you're arranging a master's item.
Oh, he also has ears.
Well, I have a master's item.
What kind of a match?
A perfect fit.
Perfect fit.
Like a glove?
Like a glove.
This match is not exactly a measure.
Exactly to measure. Perfect fit. Like a glove.
Marco, quit talking like a tailor and just tell me who is it.
Please don't shout at me.
yourself? Bruce, be out of your mind. You must be crazy. He must be crazy. Arranging a match for yourself. What are you, the guest, the bridegroom, the matchmaker, all rolled into one? I suppose you even perform the ceremony yourself. You must be crazy.
Please don't shout at me, Rectavia. As for being my own matchmaker, I know it's a little unusual.
Unusual is crazy!
Times are changing, Rectavia. The thing is, your daughters, Ix and I, gave each other our pledge over than a year ago that we would marry.
Gave each other a pledge?
Yes, Papa. We gave each other our pledge.
Gave each other a pledge?
Unheard of! Absurd!
Gave each other a pledge? Unthinkable. Where do they think they are?
In Moscow? In Paris?
Where do they think they are?
America? And what do you think you're doing? You stitcher! You nothing! Who do you think you are? King Solomon? This isn't the way it's done. Not here, not now. Some things I will not, I cannot allow. Tradition. Marriages must be arranged by the papa. This should never be changed. One little time I pulled out the prop, and where does it stop? Where does it stop? Where does it stop?
Or do I not have anything to say about my daughter? Does no one have to ask a father anymore?
I wanted to ask you for some time now, Rectavia. But first I want to save up for my own sewing machine.
Otto, quit talking nonsense! You're just a poor tailor!
That may be true, Rectavia. But even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness. Well, I promise you, your daughter will not starve.
He's beginning to talk like a man. Tommy Elliot.
What kind of a match would that be for my sight?
On the other hand, he is an honest, hard worker. On the other hand,
he has absolutely nothing.
On the other hand,
things could never get worse for him. They could only get better.
Gave each other a pledge.
Unheard of. Absurd.
They gave each other a pledge. Unthinkable. Look at my daughter's face. She loves him. She wants him. And look in my daughter's eyes. So hopeful.